You didn't think to tell me you were selling your house?
Oh, it's just bizarre.
We're seeing each other. I'm a lawyer. Why wouldn't you tell me you're selling your house?
It's not a secret. We're just renting now instead of owning. We still get to live there.
Oh, you should tell me these things. I can get them done properly for you.
Not everything has to go for you. I don't need a babysitter.
That's just all I want to do is help.
There he is. Dennis the Menace.
Fergus. Can you give us a minute?
Sure. No rush. Just got to get some paperwork with you. I'll be outside.
What? Paperwork?
Leaseholds, boiler, electrical stuff.
I see you've got yourself a business partner.
And now I've given you cash to pay your debts, perhaps you'll start thinking about putting your thieving days behind you, Rusty. Save Trish having to put a padlock on the tiller, you know.
It was just the once. I was going to put the money back in.
James!
This morning, I think you owe me a box of chocolates for covering your horrible year nines.
Or I could cook you dinner at our new house. George and I think we might have found somewhere.
Wow, that was quick.
Yeah. Is that a congratulations?
Yes, of course, congratulations. You know, George and I haven't always seen eye to eye, but if you think, hold that thought. Oi! Junior mentoring might have got you out of my lesson, but it doesn't get you out of my homework. I want a 2,000-word essay by tomorrow morning on your post-school ambitions. You can add it to your personal statement for your UCAS applications. Come on, this should be exciting. Your futures lie right outside that door. How do you plan to leave your mark on this world, Sid?
Why do we have to leave a mark, right? There's so much pressure on us. Can't we just live normal lives?
No life is normal. And everyone leaves a mark. You're incredibly privileged that you get to choose what that is.
Well, this will take me an hour, tops. I know exactly what I want to do.
Excellent.
So, do you approve of my life choices, what I want to do with my life?
George and I had professional misunderstanding, but I am happy for you. Who am I to say what is in your heart? And if you know, you know, and you clearly do.
I do.
Have a good day. It's Fergus, isn't it? Let me guess the scam. Mortgage fraud? The quick sale cost cutter? How exactly are you planning on stealing Steve's home from him?
Stealing? No, we struck a fair deal, mate. And don't worry, we used a proper lawyer to help us.
You were the bully. Growing up, weren't you? Always picking on the weak. I won't allow you to do that to Steve.
Weak, am I? Maybe that's why I don't tell you about my life, because all I get is disapproval.
Yeah, I forgot the popcorn.
Get out of here. Well, don't act the victim. I'm not allowed to feel annoyed at you for cutting me out of this enormous decision. I can't just sit back and watch you destroy your life.
And there it is, right there. You don't trust me.
How can I, when I hear that you've been thieving Trish's cash? That's low, Steve.
Okay, I admit. There's no excuse. And I'm sorry if you feel like I'm deceiving you, but I have to fix my own problems. James, I've stumbled my way through life, mistake after mistake, and I'm surprised as anybody else I'm still here. So I'm not going to let my kids down again. I'm going to provide for them now, and I need to sort that myself.
I just want to help. That's all. I think you're making a huge mistake with this deal. Let me have a look, that's all.
I have to do this on my own. I don't get to feel like an adult in this relationship. You need to start treating me as an equal from now on. Can you do that for me, please?
You know, I've always wanted a house with a name. High House Manor or something.
Oh, maybe that could be our next one.
I could be your sexy butler.
It appears we've made the same plans. Why not join us for a celebration?
What's the occasion?
I think we've found our dream house.
Pull up a chair.
Oh, we could be civil, can't we? Especially given the good news.
Let's, rather quick. Don't you think?
I suppose you're in that impulsive stage.
Well, it seemed like the logical time. Everything just felt right between us.
Yeah, well, I can see why. John Ball's a catch. Luckily, we enjoy a friendship with him, despite our history. But maybe he's found the one.
At last. Some would even say that his taste has matured.
Right, why don't I get these guys a drink?
Maybe you should cool it on the drinks. Yeah?
Yeah, I just...
Maybe we've overstayed our welcome. You two have clearly got some issues you have to discuss. Play nice, George.
No, don't worry about us. Nothing a policeman and a teacher can't iron out. Gets a bit trickier when it comes to criminals, though. As we both know. A dodgy lawyer and a racist cleaner.
I am so sorry about him.
A dodgy lawyer. That's good. I have heard worse. But please don't reduce Stee to being just a cleaner. He's actually taking night classes to become an accountant. So it'll actually be the dodgy lawyer and the accountant. That's not so bad, is it?
Maybe them would be equal.
Stee?
Seems like you two have some things to work out. So, you're sorry about me, are you?
Why are you so ashamed of me, eh? Of what I do for a living?
I was defending you against George, the condescending pig. I thought accountant was a nice touch. You look hot in a suit.
I can handle it when you're being stuck up when it comes to what wine you drink or what movie we watch, but we agreed you was going to treat me as your equal. I guess you can't do that.
I was just trying to lighten the mood by apologising for me like I'm one of your students.
Stop behaving like one of my students then. It was obvious what you were doing, trying to wind James up like that. My 11-year-olds demonstrate more subtlety.
Oh, you want to talk about subtlety? How about the way you were eating up Steve with those hungry eyes?
What?
I thought it was just James that you drool over. But hey, why stop this?
And stop with the damn drinking!
You are blowing this completely out of proportion.
No, you put more effort into impressing John Paul than you have into our entire relationship. I know that it grates on you that I'm nothing like him.
I hardly even noticed he was there.
Oh, give me a break, James. I'm sorry that I'm not the man you hoped I'd be.
Of course you are. Can we just drop this?
You don't get to decide when we're done. I need an apology.
Look, let's just go to bed. I'm tired.
No. Not this time.
Stee and I are nothing.
You're just using me to make him jealous. That's it. That's what this is.
I'm not the one with a problem with my past, all right? That's you. And you make me feel completely worthless for it, too. Should I just expect this now? Is this our life together, yeah?
I'm tired, too. You can't even give me an apology. Which just shows me how serious you are about us.
You're so out of touch with reality, you can't even see!
And that worthlessness that you feel, that doesn't come from me, mate. Go and take a walk and sober up. I can't even bear to look at you.
I'll tell you one thing. Stee never made me feel like this.
You look like we've had the same kind of evening.
I'm so confused, Stee. When things are good with me and George, it's like this energy, this electric energy, and then when things are bad, he makes me feel guilty for even drawing breath. I'm not a bad person, am I?
We're all rotten to the core. It's about who's better at pretending, darling.
It's not your James impression.
I could do George if you like. It's a bit like Sean Connery. Yeah.
No, never compare George to Sean Connery, all right? Definitely not in front of him. His ego will go through the roof.
You're not a bad person, John Paul. You're gentle, kind, Some of the best years of my life was being married to you.
So why did we throw it all away?
I mean, we had fun, didn't we?
I mean, well, it wasn't all sunshine and rainbows, but it was real.